Hello children, today I have come up once again with another grammar topic and it is related to pronouns. Pronouns, in my earlier video I told you pronouns are those words that we use in place of nouns. Pronouns have many types, means there are many types of pronouns we have in English, but the most important type of pronouns, it is this one, personal pronoun. Children, there are many students, even the students of secondary class, who are not aware about the proper use of these personal pronouns. Surprisingly, even ironically, they are not aware how many types of personal pronouns we have in English. Okay, so today I will explain you this type in detail and you try to listen very carefully. Personal pronoun, you know, these things that we use personally, these are related to human beings. These are related to even non-living things also, which we categorize or according to singular and plural. Okay, so today we'll do this thing in detail. Personal pronouns, basically these are of three types: first person, second person, third person. Try to understand for this thing. How do we differentiate between first person, second person and third person? See, first person, basically these things we relate to those things, those people who are normally speakers. Suppose I am speaking, I am first person. Right now I am singular, it means only singular. When there are many speakers, okay, we. So these are personal, means which one? These are first person. Then we think about the listeners. Listeners, they are always considered as second person. Okay, who is just in front of you. Okay, whenever you give instruction to just the person opposite to you, that is second person. Okay, so first person is speaker, second person who is just in front of you, and whatever remains, those are third person. Okay, listen carefully again. First person, it is also divided, means all the persons, they are divided into two main categories, singular and plural. So listen here, I and we, and I hope you will go through this particular line, this particular line. Okay, it is always used as subject. That is why one particular use, it is named as nominative. Means this particular category, it is always used as subject. Okay, all the things, they come later. So I, singular, we, plural, first person. Then second person, you. See, you, it is considered singular as well as plural, because all the helping verbs that we use with you, they are always in plural form. Okay, like whether only one listener is there, I'll say you have, you are. So are and have, these are plural helping verbs. Okay, so you, it is used as singular as well as plural. Then we have third person. Third person we categorize into different forms. Again, I told you, singular and plural. So he, she, it, these are singular. Then we have they, these are plural. Okay, so they, it is plural. He, she, it, these are singular. So accordingly we shall use. Okay, Suppose there are other things, so there also we can categorize them into singular and plural. So one more time I tell you, this particular line, it is always used as subject, because it is known as nominative use. All the helping verbs, they are used, suppose we are making simple sentences, so they will be used after these, and we are making, when we are making interrogative use, so all the helping verbs, they will come in the beginning. Now the second use, in second category, it is this type, my and mine. Okay, I, my and mine. So this line, this particular line, it is used as possessive adjective. Possessive means they have something with them, means all the nouns, these will be used after these. These will be considered as adjective, these will be considered as determiners also, possessive determiners. Like my pen, suppose I am using here pen, my pen, so pen will be noun, and this is possessive adjective, possessive determiner. So in the same way, okay, our, your, his, her, their, its, all these are used as possessive adjectives. Okay, then we have one more category, possessive pronouns. Okay, these are possessive pronouns. There is one common thing, or you can say unique thing, between these two categories. See, suppose you are willing to use noun after, so you use that noun here with possessive adjective. And suppose you are willing to use these words, or suppose you are willing to use noun in the beginning, so at that time you use these words. Okay, take one example here, like this pen is mine. Okay, or this is my pen. So here the word mine, see, noun we have used in the beginning, so that is why it is possessive pronoun. This is my pen, so we have used noun later, so that is why it is possessive adjective. Because any adjective, when do we say any word adjective? When it is followed by a noun. Okay, so these things you should be very much careful. Now we come to the last category, that is objective. It is also known as accusative. This particular line, it is always used as object. Means all these words you can see here, these are always used as object. Means here you can relate here, this first line, the verb will be followed after this line, and here these words will be used after the verb. Okay, means this particular category, like he helps me, the word is help. Okay, and he is subject, and me is here object. So all these words are used in the same sense. There are some children who have some confusion about it, like you is there and you is here. So how can they differentiate between these two words? Like how can they tell whether you is object, whether you is subject? It is very simple. If the word you, it is used after the word or after the verb, it is object. And when this particular word, it is just before it, so there it is subject. Like you are watching a video, so watching is verb, so you is subject. Okay, they always help you, so the word help, it is coming just before you, so that is why it is here object. Okay, yes, one more problem that the student often faces. Use of there. See, it is related to human being. There, it has some kind of belongingness. It has some kind of relation. So some children, whenever they are asked or they often write, when they often speak, they use this kind of word, T-H-E-R-E. T-H-E-R-E and T-H-E-I-R, both are different. Clear? So, here it's a kind of dummy subject, or it is mentioned for some kind of place. And here it is related to they. Okay? Like, they care their belongings. Okay? Or, he goes there daily. So, both are different. Clear? So, I hope you understood this particular type. In the next video, I'll tell you about the other types of pronouns. There are many, but the most important, it is this one. So, when you understand this particular thing, you will find that you have controlled many mistakes that you often used to do. Okay? So, I hope you understood well. Soon, I'll be coming up with other videos to explain other types of pronouns. Okay? Thank you.